When this struggle is over, we shall wear the victor's crown.
At least 250 pieces of evidence by Chagulanyi's lawyers were yesterday rejected by the Supreme Court for being filed out of time. These and many more are part of the sworn affidavits into the election petition against the Electoral Commission, President Yoweri Museveni and the Attorney General, demanding an annulment of the January 14th presidential election. The National Unity Platform leader Robert Chagulanyi Sentamu says rejecting these affidavits is conspiracy between the government and the judiciary to deprive Ugandans of a free and fair hearing of the petition.
We think that the Supreme Court is in a conspiracy. For example, I must also cite this. In the previous presidential election petition of Amama Mbabazi versus Museveni, the submissions went on way into a whole week. Lawyers would submit orally, verbally, and the nation, the population, the world was able to follow. But because the Supreme Court knows, in my opinion, that they would be put to shame, that this case will expose them to the last, the Supreme Court decided to reduce the hearing of this case to only 30 minutes. You can imagine that the previous presidential election petition submissions went on for a whole week.
Chagulanyi has threatened to withdraw his petition and instead take it to what he termed as a court of public opinion. He accuses the court of bias and lack of independence.
Maybe I'll put it more clearly. If we don't get justice in the Supreme Court, or if we see that the Supreme Court is actually not up to giving the people of Uganda justice, we shall go to the court of the people of Uganda. Now, this has very many, this is a very relative approach. The people of Uganda, like I've said in the past and I'm saying now, they shall have the final say in the matters of their destiny. Many, many things can be resolved in that line. And moving forward, we shall guide on various ways.
This is not the first time the opposition politician has doubted the credibility of the judiciary, even though he runs to the same courts seeking justice.
...of the Supreme Court. People like the Honorable Mike Chibita, who we all know was a private secretary for legal affairs in Mr. Museveni's office for 7 years. We also know that the Honorable Ezekiel Muhanguzi is a relative to General Eli Tumwine, a person that the national and international community has castigated for abusing human rights, a very, very powerful regime apologist, has a relative who is going to determine the fate of his boss. So we join all voices that are demanding for them to excuse themselves, to recuse themselves from hearing this case, because we do not expect any justice from them.
Meanwhile, Chagulanyi says his party will tomorrow file a petition to the United Nations offices requesting them to intervene in the rampant kidnapping of their members. He says over 250 people are currently unaccounted for.
More than 3,000 of our supporters and members have been arrested. Among them, some have been released on bail. Some are still incarcerated, while others are still missing. But particularly, the ones that have been abducted and are still missing are 243. And this is only just the first part, because more relatives keep coming to us reporting with the details of those that have been abducted and kidnapped, and the numbers keep rising.
Chagulanyi also accuses some religious leaders of resorting to religious dealing, which promotes the agenda of the oppressors instead of winning souls to Christ.
We shall wear the victor's crown in the new Uganda.